On Sydney's western fringe is a picturesque doggy sanctuary.
Welcome to the Animal Welfare League.
I'm here to get a dog.
You're in the right place.
Where dedicated staff...
I think we're going to find you a home.
...pair the orphaned and abandoned with hopeful new owners.
Oh my gosh.
To see if lives can be changed by the perfect match.
Oh,
hi.
Oh. Honey.
Dogs that are in desperate need of love and individual care. And as soon as we find one dog a loving family, we just rescue another one.
Hello.
Hello, Seth.
Hey, gun. Hello. Who's this?
This is little Ash.
Little Ash?
Yes. He's a miniature Australian shepherd.
Yeah, he's
about four and a half years old.
The reason it's Renda.
And the owner passed away, unfortunately.
Oh, I like Stephen.
He loves Stephen.
You all right?
Sorry.
Wee, little good boy.
Here. Oh, thank you.
Oh, I've never seen a mini Australian shepherd.
Me neither. You ready to go? Let's go. Wee!
Hey, buddy.
It's a never-ending cycle, but these little characters are worth it.
Ladies first.
Tom and James are dog lovers. One has a dog, one doesn't. But that's about to change.
Dog.
Hello.
Hi, how you going?
Good.
I'm Tom.
How's it going?
This is James.
Yeah, here to meet a dog.
And are you guys best friends?
This is my younger brother.
Oh.
Everyone thinks he's older.
Older and wiser?
Probably not. We have a pretty special relationship as brothers. From a young age, it's always been sharing rooms and growing up and similar friends groups, travelled the world together. Like, yeah, we've been inseparable.
And so who's the dog for today?
Me. I've got a little cavoodle, a little black and tan cavoodle. His name's Alfie. When Thomas stays over, he steals Alfie and sleeps with him in bed, which creates a bad habit, which we had to break.
It just proves to me that I need to get my own dog.
Alright, thanks, Ed. Sydney,
moving back to Newcastle in a couple of weeks.
The move back to Newcastle is definitely step. Like, it's definitely moving towards a settling down, and the dog's definitely the first step of that. Thank you. Treat for the little boy.
Hi, guys.
Hello.
How are you going?
Good, yourself?
Good.
Hi.
Give us a bit of an idea of your dream dog. What are you sort of picturing?
I'm thinking something sort of a little bit younger. Probably medium size, sort of like anything from sort of border collie, kelpie, up to lab kind of size. I want to try to be quite active with the dog.
Go to the pub with him.
Nice.
So you need a little friend to spend the days with when the bro's not around.
Yeah. I've been single for a little while now and lived by myself as well for the past 3 years. So at times, you know, it's nice to have a bit of company. The connection in general is probably what I'm looking for.
Okay. Medical conditions, that something that might be a bit off-putting for you guys?
The only thing is, because I'm going to be living by myself, there's going to be times I'm going to have to leave the dog at home.
Yeah.
For it to be able to be alone for periods of time.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'd like an affectionate sort of dog as well.
He's definitely a big softie. He's got a lot of love to give, sometimes too much, and it gets a bit overbearing. Let's go for one tolerant dog, I think. Work your magic.
Of course.
Thanks.
Yeah,
try our best.
He's the affectionate one. I'm definitely not. He's a big teddy bear.
I'm not a big softie, mate. I love free drink cold beers.
We want active.
Yeah.
We want medium to large size.
Well, we do have Frank.
Yeah, I was thinking Frank.
So cute.
Oh, look at his face.
Oh, that's the sweetest face.
Look at the little stripe down his head.
So Frank's favourite things are fetch and playing with balls. Affection from my favourite people. Who are his favourite people?
Possibly could be me.
Oh, of course it is.
Yeah, I mean, I just think Frank has a few more things he needs work on.
Okay.
And for someone who's probably not a dog
on his own.
Yeah.
I don't want to bombard him with, here's your young, jumpy, mouthy, frustrated dog.
Yeah, that can't be left alone. Because he said he does want to be able to work and the dog leaves him alone for a little bit.
Yeah. So his favourite breed is kelpies?
Yeah.
So we do have Keira.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That was the other one I was thinking of.
Your favourite things are balls, toys and more balls. We love them. Loves running. Good.
Is she going to be okay to be left alone for a few hours in a day?
She does get a little bit barky.
Yeah.
A little bit jumpy.
Yeah.
Mild anxiety. Not in the sense where
she's not
had to medicate her.
Yeah.
Keira would be easier to train than Frank would.
I think Kira's a really good option.
Yeah.
And she's pretty.
Yeah.
See, it can be a big problem within the shelter. The kennel environment is quite stressful for dogs. A lot of the dogs have been separated from their owners and they haven't been socialised properly. So if the dogs are chewing the bars and barking constantly, we'll do a lot to calm them down. We use slow feeders like licky mats to reduce anxiety and boredom within the kennels.
Hey, miss. Are you having a bad day? Play some music.
A lot of dogs respond really well to music therapy. And it can help with drain out all the barking around the kennel environment. Trying to reduce anxiety as much as possible is a key thing for us.
Is she nervous then? Oh, not really.
I was this morning, but now I'm more just excited to meet the dog.
Hello. All right. So, we think we have found you the right girl.
Okay.
She's your little wing woman.
Yep.
She's going to probably just take a little bit of time to get to know you, but when she gets to know you, she's going to be very cuddly, very smoochy.
Her name is Keira.
Keira.
And she is a little kelpie cross.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. That's three that you're after.
Okay.
Age-wise, she's three and a bit.
Yeah. That sounds good, doesn't it? That sounds really good. Sounds perfect. Taking all the
How are you feeling?
That's amazing. Yeah. That's really exciting.
Now she does have some mild separation anxiety, but nothing crazy. So when you leave, she just does an initial bark, a little bit of bouncing, but can settle.
Okay. People experience things in life and they deal with them differently. I think adversity can really bolster your personality and make you a stronger person.
And it looks like she's really into pats, but you have a little bit of talents tucked under, so just very gradual with her.
Yeah. Okay. I like to think that dogs are very similar, provided that they've given the opportunity to flourish and grow and show that there is a different side of life.
She's a really sweet girl. She just takes some time.
Well, did you guys want to meet her?
Of course.
Yeah.
I build it up like that. I feel like a blind date. You don't know what to expect. Finally get to meet her. Finally. you don't know if you're going to get along with them. Be a disaster, or it could be the love story that you're looking for. The fairy tale story.
Fairy tale. They're so hot. I was like,
ding, 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 ding.
Everything's messed up. Dogs have always been a part of our family. I love dogs so much. I obviously have mine. God, I can't see that.
Brothers Tom and James expecting their blind date, Keira the Kelpie. Will it be love at first sight?
He's get full of that little nervous energy. Just get that first pat in and then go from there.
Hi. Hello, sweetheart. What are you doing?
This is Keira, a 3-year-old Kelpie cross. Good girl. Keira is a very fun, playful dog, very energetic. She's constantly in motion. Keira likes to play with toys, definitely balls, ropes, tug of war. Wait. Unfortunately, we do find a lot of the dogs that come through the shelter, once they get adopted or go to a new home, they tend to show signs of separation anxiety.
Good girl.
But Keira is a very sweet and affectionate girl. She's just looking for someone to love.
Look at her at the end of the lead.
I'm excited.
She walks so nice.
Here we go. She's keen. She's beautiful.
He looks really happy.
Look at her excited face.
Is this Keira?
Hi, Keira.
Hello. Hello, darling. Hey, aren't you gorgeous? Hey, you're beautiful.
You see that tail, the tail tuster?
Yeah.
So you probably noticed we don't have any toys in here.
Yeah, at the moment.
She's pretty toy obsessed, so we kind of wanted her to really get to know you
before she
really get an idea until she goes into that play mode as well. But
she's a bit of a nervous Nelly.
She is, yeah.
Enjoy.
Thanks, mate. Appreciate that.
Poor little thing. A little bit nervous.
Let her do her thing. She's gorgeous. Yeah, beautiful.
He seems pretty interested, but they've got to give Keira a second.
Yeah.
Be walking over to her yet.
Yeah.
Go smell all the other dogs that have been through.
That's right. Could be a little bit of a worry, ignoring him.
Yeah.
I love the colour. It's beautiful colour.
Hello. You want to come for a cuddle?
Rejected.
You like to look around, see how beautiful she is. Just want to get that connection.
What do you reckon?
Well, these two brothers have such a good bond.
It's good to call your brother your mate as well.
Yeah.
Go explore every square inch. Definitely looked after me for as long as I can remember. So he's obviously going to look after the dog.
Our mum passed away when we were 5, and James is only 3 years old. I feel like responsibility for his welfare as well. You know, Mum was my age when she passed away, so I feel so young, and I think about that, and I just can't imagine how hard it must have been for her to say goodbye to 3 kids under the age of 7. No, she's gorgeous. Little Keira. Yeah. One of the best things my dad did was he filmed a lot of her last sort of months and days and that sort of stuff, and she spoke to us specifically through the camera and left a message, which has been really, 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 really important to me.
So how excited are you about getting a dog?
1,100,000, if that's a number, out of 10.
Izzy and Lily have been campaigning hard for a dog, and at last, Mum Jane's come to the party.
I'm going to give the dog about this much love, or maybe even more.
Hello.
Hello.
Good morning.
Good morning. Welcome to the Animal Welfare League. My name's Jade. What brings you guys out today?
To look for a dog. Lily's 10, she's nearly 11, and Izzy's 13. I think they've been patient enough in understanding that they do have to be a good age to get a dog.
If you happen to get a dog today, where do you think it will sleep?
Lily's room.
Lily's room?
Lily's room.
Lily's room?
Mine's always messy.
Okay.
I like dachshunds, Rottweilers, poodles, jugs and pugs.
Okay, thank you.
No worries.
We'd like a rescue dog because we've been through some tough experiences ourselves, and to give the dog some love and give it a new home and a positive upbringing.
Oh, are those kittens? Oh my God.
It's like she's sussing the whole thing out.
Keira. Keira.
Bachelor Tom is still trying to connect with Keira, who's playing hard to get.
Tom wants a dog who's going to be quite.
That's right.
Could be a little bit of a worry. Yeah. I haven't known him.
When you start to develop separation anxiety issues.
Yep.
Got to sniff them all.
Keira. Keira. Come here.
Good girl. Good girl.
Oh, look how responsive she is.
Good job, sweet. And the tail's still going.
Yep.
There you go. Isn't
she gorgeous?
You got a couple of greys like me.
Oh,
she's getting a little bit iffy with him.
Yeah.
There's a bit of a submission. aggressive behaviour because her tail's not wagging up.
Yeah, all a bit stressed. It's so hard to read when they roll on their back like that if it's an enjoying thing. But, I mean, who wouldn't enjoy tummy pats from Tom?
She loves it. She loves being close to you. Yeah, she's like rubbing up against your leg. Hello, darling. Covered in hair in no time.
Ah, well, price you pay.
That's it.
She's not 100% comfortable, but she's pretty comfortable.
She's
and for her, this is awesome.
Well. Yeah.
So, like, the tail's coming in a little bit and she's got a bit of an open mouth, but she's still pretty loose.
That's right.
Obviously, the commitment of having a dog's huge. I don't think it's something he would do unless he was willing to commit to it.
Do you guys want to take it for a walk?
Yeah, that'd be grateful. Yeah, the separation anxiety, I'll just have to wait and see. Girl, this way. Good girl. She's leading the way. She knows what she's doing. Yeah.
Often require extra medical support. And the on-site vet clinic treats over 1,000 dogs a year. It's here rescues are given the once-over to ensure they're in good health.
It's really important for the dogs that come into our care to have an incoming health check, as some of the dogs haven't seen a vet in a very long time. There could be quite a few ongoing health issues.
12.45, that's not too bad.
It is really beneficial to have our own veterinary clinic here. We can take any emergency cases there. We can get any of our dogs checked at any time.
Ash is saying, hi, Nicole.
Hi, Bree.
We've got Ash here today.
Oh, hello, little man.
There we go.
Hello, Mr. Ash.
So he's just getting his incoming health check today.
You've already been
dissexed,
I see. Let's have a little listen to your heart.
Good boy, Ash.
You're in pretty good health, aren't you?
Ash's vet check went really well. Very sweet. Seems very healthy and will be shortly into a home.
Okay, we'll see you later, Mr. Ash.
All right, come on.
Before school and after school?
I'm out for the one before school because I need my beauty sleep until 8 o'clock exact.
So I guess it'll be late, hey?
Probably.
Hello, guys.
Hello.
Why are we here today? What are we looking for?
For our forever dog.
Your forever dog. Perfect.
So what personality-wise do you guys look for in a dog?
A little bit crazy, but not crazy all the time. A little bit of personality.
A dash of crazy.
What breeds do you love?
Dash hounds. Caboodles.
Is that because they're really cute and you could dress them up in like little sausage outfits?
Mm-hmm. Or like a little pink tutu.
Yeah.
So what sort of life, I guess, is this dog looking at living with you guys?
I think the dog will be pretty active.
Yeah?
Could take it to
like
netball.
Yeah.
But also someone that's happy to sit and have a cuddle.
Yeah, something with a little bit of energy but also snuggle.
So what are you guys as a family hoping that this dog is going to bring?
I guess just extra companionship.
Yeah.
We've all got different types of anxiety, but I guess the one that we probably all have together is, I guess, being a little bit introverted. Somebody that's there to, when we come home.
Yeah.
Somebody to meet and greet us with a big lick and a cuddle. I guess understanding the anxieties, especially with Izzy, is that you can't see it. You can't see anxiety because it's inside. You can feel it. Your throat, your stomach.
So leave it with us. We'll go have a chat and try and find you your new best friend.
Okay, great. I think a dog will help us if we're feeling anxious or worried by just giving us love. A dog is like children in a way that children can reach you to. So just coming up and giving you that hug. Mum, you need a hug. Dogs are like that too. Or just give you that glance. You need some love.
Hmm? Oh, we didn't even mention like a little French bulldog.
No, I was meant to be like excited, but then I snorted.
Don't worry, I snort when I laugh.
So it's two daughters and the mum.
Yeah.
They're quite active, so they play netball, they go dancing. Probably a social dog. Pretty much the main thing that kept us a small dog.
All right, we're going off that, and then I think let's match up Lily with Lily.
Lily with Lily.
Lily with Lily.
That's cute. I like that.
She is a 3.5-year-old pug mix.
Lily's a really cute dog, and yeah. She's so bouncy and happy. Love Lily. And loving. She's had so many meet and greets.
But the good thing is she absolutely adores kids.
Do we still have Alfonso and Lorenzo here?
Yes, we do. Alfonso and Lorenzo have come out of the shell a little bit. They're still not the best with new people.
Yeah, I feel like they need to deal with high-pitched screaming, lots of movement, kids running around.
I feel like Lily would be the best fit. Yeah. She is the most confident dog we have here, probably.
Yeah. Really hope that in the meeting pen they get to see crazy Lily, but they get to see chill Lily.
Definitely agree. I think we're all on the same page with that one.
Yeah.
She's perfect. Plus, they have the same name. It's meant to be.
Yeah.
So we had a really, really good look. We do have a pug.
Okay.
Mix. Mm-hmm. Yeah. She's an absolute piggy. She is very cheeky.
Mm-hmm. She loves and adores people.
Yeah. Okay. That perfect mix of like, we'll go crazy around the yard, play with toys, but then we'll sleep and snore. Yeah. And you're not going to believe her name. Her name is Lily.
Oh,
yeah. So there you go.
Yep.
How are you guys feeling?
Yeah, I want
it. Yeah. Are we
excited? Yeah.
I want it. Like, yes. I'm hoping Lily will be just like me.
That Lily is bossy a lot.
I think she's going to be really good for all three of you guys, and she adores kids. Yeah. Do we want to meet Lily?
Yes.
Yeah?
You do?
Yeah. All right, awesome.
Rescuing a dog, you can, I guess, make its life more happier with a new family and everything.
And we want the dog to be happy, not always sad.
Thanks, guys.
Good luck. Bye.
We could call Lily Piggy, because she's like a pig, as Lily. I said.
Lily Pilly.
Ready, Lily? Lily is a pug mix who's 3 years old. I think Lily is absolutely amazing. Let's go. I think any family would be blessed to have her in their life just because she does put a smile on your face no matter what mood you're in. She's always happy to entertain you. She loves to play with toys and loves food, loves peanut butter.
Good job.
She has had a few meet and greets. Unfortunately, none of them have been successful so far. However, I think there's a perfect home out there, so we're just waiting for the perfect home to come around.
Who wants to open the door?
I'm not opening it, I'm too scared.
Okay. Good girl, Lily.
I really want Lily to get
her. Energy-wise, she just hasn't been the right fit for many people.
I think it'll be good for Mum to have a dog because if she's in lots of stress, she can have a dog to take her off her stress.
Dogs can take you away to another world.
Excited.
I'm excited too. I couldn't think. Come on.
Unsuccessful matchups. Ever hopeful Lily Pug is about to meet the Wilkinsons.
Come on. Good girl. Come on.
Oh, hey, guys.
Come on, Lily.
Oh, God, that is so cute.
Oh, my God. So this is Lily. They all have a toy ready for her.
They look excited.
Hello, Lily.
Hello.
Wow. Lily really likes
them.
Are you happy if I let her off lead?
Yeah.
Yes, please.
So I'll give you guys some treats, but just don't give it too many.
Okay. I hope she does a little zoom. She gets all happy and then they sort of feed off that energy.
I might go and leave you to it.
Okay.
Hello.
Oops.
Oh. Lily.
Lily.
Hello, Lily. That's my name.
Hello.
Izzy, I'm trying to give her a treat, okay? Izzy, put it down for a second. See, look.
Sit. She can't sit. She's too excited.
She can't sit. She loves you so much.
For that tail girl.
Yeah, there you go.
I was going to give her one.
You can give her another one. Just the three of us, so yeah, we've got to get on. Sometimes we can bicker, and Izzy now being a teenager is showing a lot more challenges. We can both get annoyed with each other.
Yes, you love her.
Izzy was one of a preemie twin born at 24 weeks. She was the second twin. She had a sister, Zoe. Unfortunately, Zoe had a bleed on the brain and she passed away after a couple of days. The hope. And she's still here today to show what a courageous little fighter she is. She's amazing. They said she'd never make it, but she did. It's been a trauma.
Yes.
Jane looks like she's really thinking.
She's got her thinking hat on.
Ready? Set. Go.
It's a lot to take on. You've got two active girls and you're adding another active girl that you're caring for solely on your own.
Yeah, it's a big job.
After 20 years of wedded bliss, Paul and Diana are ready to share their love with a rescue dog.
Many, many years ago, I went to this party. I remember sort of meeting her and sitting down and I had a few drinks. She was sitting with a girlfriend who also had blonde hair.
Oh, hi there. Welcome to the AWL. I'm Mark.
I rang him up a few days later and asked him out. And when I got to the door, he wasn't sure who I was.
Yeah. I'll just move this out of the way for you if you want to come over here.
One of the reasons that she always wants to be with me is I have a disabled parking permit. She loves it when we go out and we can park.
Always find somewhere to park.
So what do you want? A lap dog.
A lap dog. Affectionate. Cheeky dog.
Something with character.
Something with character.
To pay for what it needs.
Sit. 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 You're kidding. Sit. No. Oh, I dropped it.
Good girl.
Good girl. You can learn some other tricks. I don't have any more.
We can relate to dogs having challenges. We've had lots of challenges in our lives. So, yes, we understand that it may not be easy.
Lulu, I thought you were talking for me for a second. And they said Lily, I was like, yeah. You gotta get in there. Oh, she moved. Oh, I got it.
Like a happy distraction.
Yes,
from any sort of sad thing or any hardships that I might be having.
Hello. Oh, hello.
There's Lily with Lily. Look.
That is so cute.
I think the dog will help Mum with her stress.
It will, like, cheer her up a lot.
Oh, you like little pets?
I think a dog will help with my anxieties. A dog can read those anxieties and help us to refocus our attention on something else. A dog will take us away into another world.
Okay, we have so many things in common. Name? Oh, yeah. We like beds.
Snorting when you get excited.
Oh, I really hope they take her.
Yeah, she's been here quite a while, poor Lily.
I really want Lily to get out of the shelter. It's about time she needs it.
Hello. Oh my gosh, she looks a bit too comfortable.
She's just sitting with Lily.
I think she's telling us something.
All right, well, we might take her for a walk if you guys are happy to do that.
Yeah. I guess I like to think about things and mull them over and go through the positives and negatives. It's a huge decision to get a dog, to make sure that it's not only the right dog for us, but to make sure that we can manage and look after a dog. Who's leading the way? Which Lily?
And what are we doing here today?
Looking for a dog.
A dog? And what does that dog look like?
Smallish.
Smallish.
Okay.
To be honest, I think I would prefer a furrier dog.
Yeah.
Don't want a designer dog, really.
Yeah, no.
Something that's got character.
Yep. Okay. Yeah. Also, not scared of wheels.
Sure. Okay. So that's going to be a bit tricky. Obviously, a lot of these dogs probably have never seen a wheelchair before.
No.
Most dogs are probably going to be a bit scared to start off with, but we'll get lots of yummy involved,
yes.
And try and work out, of course. Yeah, yeah.
It'd be nice to have a dog that I could go out with.
Mm. Our joke is that you could take Paul for a walk.
Okay.
We're not serious, but you know, it'd be more like to be sitting on his lap.
Yeah, right.
So you want a dog that's small enough to get into your lap then, I guess?
Yeah. It'd be nice. The fact that if it's a small dog, that it can jump on his lap, you know, in his wheelchair, if he's literally watching television or whatever. I mean, having a dog just sort of just sit there and just, have fun. I don't really want a dog for Paul that will add a dimension to his life.
Yeah.
No, it's dogs, but they're just so joyful, usually. They're so sort of totally in the moment.
And dogs give you everything. They are man's best friend. I mean, it would be nice to have a dog that would play fetch.
Play fetch.
Is that what you're most looking forward
to do?
Come back for the ball. Yes, here. Yeah.
Yeah.
We've got the, you know, what you call the scoop things. You chuck, we've got that already.
Oh, awesome. I love that you bought everything already.
Oh, no.
I haven't even got a dog. Awesome. Go and have a chat and we'll be back with hopefully a perfect dog.
Okay.
Fingers crossed. Thank you, guys.
Nice to meet you.
You
nice
too.
Meet
you.
What are we going to eat?
Maybe nothing. Maybe no dog.
Devoted couple Paul and Diana are finally ready to share life with a new family member.
It's a bit nerve-wracking, isn't it, sitting waiting?
Be nice. No, don't be. I could let off the leash.
It would be nice. Yeah. Size-wise, is the only thing. But apart from that, any breed would be all right.
So nothing over a Staffy, but nothing smaller than a Chihuahua, I think I said?
Yeah.
Did you guys have any ideas sort of straight away?
It's a bit of a hard choice, actually.
It is.
Yeah, Ash is a smaller dog who's quite sweet.
Look at him. He is absolutely beautiful. He was living with an older owner who passed away, so he was surrendered to us.
Okay.
That's the look that they're after. She
Definitely.
Said she really wants, like, a fluffy dog.
Oh, really? Yeah,
yeah,
okay.
That can sit in his lap.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Do we think we have a second option to Ash?
See, my first thought was Lottie.
Such a sweet girl. Cute.
She would be the perfect dog for them.
Yeah.
It's just the fact that I think she's going to be too big, and I think because she's a bit bigger, if she did pull, it's going to be tricky for Paul.
What about little Lulu?
Lulu, let's get your profile up, Lulu.
Is that you? She's gorgeous. She's my little baby.
But although we love you, Miss Lou, she can be a bit barky.
Do I think that getting up and down from his wheelchair is going to be a good idea for her back. Being a Dachshund, they're prone to back problems. Diana did say fluffy.
That's why Ash is just perfect. We actually have found you a large dog in a small dog's body.
Oh. So I was like, sorry.
It's a mini Australian Shepherd. Have you ever heard of that?
No.
Nor had I till I met this little gentleman.
Yeah.
So we don't often get these cool breeds in rescues.
It's a breed. Oh,
yeah.
Good.
Mini Aussie Shepherd. So his name is Ash.
Ash.
And is an absolute delight. Such an intelligent dog.
Yeah.
So how are you guys feeling?
For a dog that might
changed my life.
I've never heard of a miniature Aussie Shepherd.
Sounds interesting.
It sounds furry.
I woke up one morning and my left hand, there was a numb spot, and it just started getting numb. After about a week, I went and saw my GP, and she referred me to a neurologist.
Right. That's pretty, isn't it?
Finally, after 3 months, he told me that I had MS, and that was a shock.
I had every choice not to be with Paul, and I chose to be with him, but I knew he had MS when we met. Right from the beginning, I knew. It's not like it came along later. It wasn't something I signed up for. I knew it was from the beginning. So my only thing is I really would hope that something will come along that will stop it getting worse.
Got ropes?
Ropes, lots of ropes.
A tire?
Ash is an Aussie Shepherd mix. Having an Aussie Shepherd in the shelter is pretty unique. He might be a working breed, but he's definitely more of a lazy boy. He's just always got to be on your lap, and he always wants to have a paw, and he's a very affectionate little man.
Thank you.
I can see Ash going to a home with anyone, really. For someone who lives a less busy life, that's happy to just sit at home with him, take him out for his walks. He loves his walks so much. He just wants someone to love him as much as he loves them.
I just hope he's not too scared of his wheelchair.
Yeah, fingers crossed. But any dog that we'd introduce to someone in a wheelchair, like, it's intimidating.
Go, Ash.
Nah, look at it.
Oh, dear. That's a big smile.
Oh, he's got that eyebrows.
Good.
Love eyebrows.
Yes.
Aren't she beautiful?
Beautiful little man is Ash.
Hey, Ash. I'm going to tell you.
Got a whole lot of love to give in that little body.
He's doing a great job. I'm very proud of him.
Yeah.
All right, well, have the best time, and I'll just be outside if you need me.
Okay, thanks.
Bye.
Hey, darling.
No, don't leave me, don't leave me.
Hey, Ash.
Yes, don't leave him, he'll come back. It's okay, Ash.
I was diagnosed in 88, and I thought, that's my life over. But it wasn't.
What I admire most is his tenacity. He doesn't give up. Like he said, you know, okay, his life changed a lot of things he can't do, but he will give everything a try.
Doesn't no, he's anxious because they've gone.
Yeah. Hey, Ash.
Don't worry. He'll come back.
Diana's a very caring and sharing person. She does everything to help me.
Come on, Ash.
Come on, Ash.
This reciprocal.
Come on.
That's what I love about him. Very much so. You know, he's a giver. He's just a bit scared.
Come on. Hello.
Yeah.
You are a galumpher.
Oh,
that's
cute.
Sweet.
Because
a tail curl.
A little wiggle butt there.
Yeah.
Hey,
look, you like a treat?
He loves a treat.
He's going to be a fat dog.
Like a big bum.
A big bum, yeah. You think he'd better sit on your lap?
I don't know.
Do you think you could try if you want with a treat? It's very food oriented. Yeah? Do you want to try?
Look, I'm in pain all the time. The only time I don't have pain is when I'm in bed at night and I've taken my medication.
Can you get up in my lap?
Do you want to come in? Come on. If he could get to a point in his life where he wasn't in pain and he wasn't going to get any worse, I'd be ecstatic, which probably sounds ridiculous because, I mean, who wants that as an aim in life? But I'd just be happy for him to have that.
Oh.
There we are. Yeah, I have to say, he is bigger than I expected.
Oh, is he too big?
I mean, I think he could be too heavy for your lap.
I'm going to get worse. I don't like to talk to Diane about it because I know she's very frightened of that.
Hey, look what I've got.
Look.
She's my support physically. I'm her emotional support. And I'm so frightened that when that goes, she will be devastated. She will.
Mini Aussie Shepherd is definitely charming Paul and Diana, but is he the right physical fit for them?
He's a small to medium, that's exactly what he is.
I think Diana was a bit shocked with how heavy he was.
Just heavy in the butt.
Just heavy in the butt, yeah.
So big bash?
The wheelchair doesn't bother you, does it?
Yeah, I don't think he's even noticed your wheels, has he? He'll move a bit further.
This will be interesting how he reacts to the wheels.
Yeah.
Had a little bit of a flinch, but I think it was a bit of a surprise.
You're food oriented, aren't you? Yes, you are.
Who are you caring about? Who's got the treat?
I don't think he's fazed by the wheelchair.
Yeah, we don't want a dog to be timid and be scared of going too far.
Good boy. Sit. Well, I think we're all settled here. I think you could be a very good couch potato.
I think you could be a very good couch potato.
He looks really happy. It's almost like an instant connection to them both, which is quite nice.
Yeah.
Who's that?
Here she is.
Hello.
How'd you go?
He is adorable.
How do you guys feel about maybe taking him for a bit of a walk?
Yeah, we thought I'd push Paul all the way to see how he goes and walk in.
Yes, beautiful.
He doesn't seem to be worried at all by Paul's wheels.
Which is amazing. It's really nice.
If something does happen to me, then if there's a dog, there's that support mechanism for Diana.
He's beautiful, isn't he?
He is.
I mean, he's just such a sweet dog.
Because pets are so responsive to your emotions.
You're doing well, Ash. Lead the way, Ash. Come this way. Come on. Nice little good boy.
I love meeting Keira. I really enjoyed taking her for a quick walk. She came straight up to us, was very playful, very affectionate. My only concern was that she had separation anxiety, and because I was going to be looking after her by myself, I was concerned that she might get a bit worked up if I had to go out. Keira! But I decided to take Keira home. It was a pretty easy decision in the end. I felt like there was a connection pretty much straight away.
I thought he might take her home.
Mm-hmm. Big sucky.
My main concern was leaving her home by herself. So I did a quick test run going down to the shops and came back 5 minutes later and she was sitting out on the front porch. I was quite proud of her in that moment that she sat there and waited for me. It's nice to have companionship. And even if she's just sitting here on the ledge and is sleeping, it's nice to have her by my side, and seeing her happy is really fulfilling.
Yeah, his life definitely revolves around Keira now.
Yeah, it is nice to have a girl in my life, even though it is a dog, but it was 3 days, and then she was up there, and now she's a massive bit on.
Future girlfriends don't stand a chance.
No chance. Yeah. Good girl.
Excited to be home?
Yeah.
Got lots of homework?
Yeah. It
was fantastic to meet Lily in the pen. She's just adorable, but it's a huge commitment. It can't just be left for me to look after her. The girls have to be involved. And I wasn't sure if it was the right thing to do to bring her home. I just didn't think it was going to be possible. But Tilly, when she came through that door, it was just instant love. Tilly.
Come on.
I think two Lilies would be complicated. We just changed her name to something close to Lily, to Tilly.
Come on. Come on. Since Tilly came home, I've certainly been less anxious. I've noticed it just sort of in my day-to-day life.
I think Mum's better with a dog. because, like, if you have Tilly there, she can always make you laugh and giggle.
If we've all had a bad day, Tilly's just always there for us.
It's a good girl.
Tilly is a playful dog. She's always happy. She's always excited. She's always wanting food. She's the best dog ever.
We loved him right from the very first book.
First sight. We had to bring him home. He was just beautiful. He's just so affectionate. I think he sees Paul's wheelchair as an extension of himself, to the extent that he cuddles up against the wheelchair, and if he doesn't want to do something, he runs under the wheelchair and hides.
So warm and friendly. He's changed my life. He's a bundle of joy. Yeah, I really enjoyed watching the bond with Diana.
I wake up in the morning, I look down, and there's his face smiling up at me. He's very lovely.
Next time on The Doghouse.
It's a really big event for me.
50 years in the making, will Missy fulfill artist Tony's dream?
Post. 9 years?
Yeah.
Can Onyx play his cards right to win over a cautious couple?
Something's wrong.
And there's a lot at stake for the Rubin sisters and this little rascal, Fox.
Not having to worry about Lucy being home alone, lonely, is just going to be amazing.
What do you think of the five?
I don't know.